Let us have a look at the conditions required for combustion. The first condition is that there should be a combustible substance. Second one is there must be a continuous supply of oxygen. And the third condition for combustion to take place is that the temperature must be above the ignition temperature of the combustible substance. Let us study these conditions one by one by performing certain activities. The first condition is very clear, that there should be a combustible substance, then only combustion will take place. Now, for the second point, that air is necessary for a combustion, we are going to perform an activity. Fix a candle on a table, light the candle and observe the flame. Now take a glass chimney here and place it as shown in this figure. Observe the candle flame carefully. You will see the candle will be burning. It is open from the top and we have some space also from below, and we can see that the candle is burning. Next, now place a cardboard on the top of the chimney and observe the flame. First, we have placed the candle, we have placed a chimney, we observe the flame of the candle, then we place the cardboard. This is how we proceed with the activity. Let us make the observations now. The first one, in this case, the candle is burning. In the second case, when we remove this, the two blocks of wood that we have kept here, when we remove them, the flame of the candle slowly subsides and it gives a smoke, black colored smoke, and it flickers. Then when we keep the cardboard over the chimney, we'll see that the flame extinguishes. This is the activity that we have performed. Now from this activity, we observe that air is necessary for combustion. When there is a supply of air, the candle is burning. When this supply is reduced, in the second case, the supply of air is reduced, it flickers and gives out black colored smoke. And then if we completely stop the supply of air, the candle stops burning. That means oxygen present in the air helps in the combustion of the fuel. It is therefore known as the supporter of combustion. Which gas is known as supporter of combustion? Oxygen is the gas that is known as the supporter of combustion. Let us see this second activity. And in this second activity, we want to make this point clear, that proper ignition temperature is required for combustion. For combustion to take place, the temperature should be according to the combustible material that we have taken. And then only the combustion will take place. In this activity, we take two paper cups. One paper cup is half full of water and the other one is empty. Keep both the paper cups on two separate spirit lamps. You can see in this diagram here, in this picture, two separate lamps are being used and the two paper cups are put on the lamps. We see that this paper cup, which was empty, that starts this paper cup, which is empty, that burns, whereas the paper cup which was containing water did not burn. Are you clear with this activity? We have taken two paper cups. One paper cup is empty, the other one is half full of water. When we place the two paper cups on two spirit lamps, the paper cup which is empty burns, whereas the paper cup which has some water in it does not burn. The piece of paper burns quickly. Here in this paper cup, the paper cup burns quickly because the required temperature for burning paper has been achieved. Whereas when we put water in this paper cup, the paper cup does not burn because water in the cup that reduces the temperature, there is a change in the temperature of the paper cup, more heat is required to burn this paper cup now. I hope this activity is clear. The temperature of the empty paper cup rises first, reaches the stage where it catches fire, and in the second case, the cup which is full of water, the temperature does not rise that fast, as the water present in the paper cup also absorbs some heat. Hence, the paper cup does not catch fire. Now, I have been using this word, ignition temperature, to burn a combustible substance. Some temperature is required by that substance to burn. The lowest temperature at which a combustible substance catches fire is called its ignition temperature or kindling temperature. Different substances catch fire at different temperatures. Have you understood the meaning of kindling temperature or ignition temperature? It is that lowest temperature at which a substance starts burning. That minimum temperature which is required for a substance to burn. Fine? And all these substances that I've shown here, I've shown very few substances. All these substances have different temperatures. This is wood. It burns on different temperature. This is coal, LPG. It burns very fast. A little bit of heat is sufficient for, I should say, a spark will be sufficient for LPG gas to catch fire. And then we have kerosene. That also burns very fast. So all these substances have different temperatures at which they catch fire. And this temperature is known as their ignition temperature.